We're going to go through all the stories, but yeah. I don't know where to start. I don't know. You can't even say what the big story of the day is, because the Kushner story last night is shocking and is going to have reverberations. It's exactly what Mueller and his investigators thought, that maybe he was playing both sides of the street. And then the NBC news that broke yesterday that Mueller now is king in. What did Donald Trump know? When did he know it? Did he know about the DNC hacking beforehand? Did he plan it? I mean, you know, again, this guy doesn't ask questions that he doesn't know the answers to. And then, of course, that gun meeting, which, of course, pretty extraordinary, where he even criticized Pat Toomey for being scared of the NRA when Toomey was the one Republican that came out after Newtown preaching the need for expanded background checks. Where do you start?
Unclear. All of that plus the departure of one of the most important people in the White House, I would argue, because of her closeness to Donald Trump, the person who was at the center of that meeting on Air Force One, where a false story was concocted that about the meeting with the Russians that could potentially be a big part of some sort of obstruction of justice case the day after. After she testified to having told white lies about for the president, and I imagine that has a really elastic definition. You know, I just before we went on, I counted seven stories of the week, not just stories of the day, but at least stories of the week, if not the month, that all happened yesterday. And frankly, some of us were not going to sleep when that Kushner story broke. Some of us were here talking about it on television. So it is just extraordinary. If you want to boil it down, chaos and corruption, I think, would be the overarching theme of yesterday. And let's not forget open warfare between the president and his own Justice Department. They had that dinner last night with Jeff Sessions and the Solicitor General and Rod Rosenstein photographed to send a message, obviously, back to the president that we're united and, you have to deal with us on that basis. Just extraordinary.
It is. Willie, extraordinary.
Right. So let's
take us through it.
Let's start with that development yesterday that seems to be indicative of a White House in some disarray, the resignation of White House Communications Director Hope Hicks. Hicks is the fourth communications director to step down from the White House following Sean Spicer, Mike Dubke, and Anthony Scaramucci. Hicks says she wants to explore opportunities outside the White House, writing in a statement, quote, "There are no words to adequately express my gratitude to President Trump. I wish the president and his administration the very best as he continues to lead our country." The president, whom the White House says was sad to hear the news, said this about Hicks in a statement, quote, "Hope is outstanding and has done great work for the last 3 years. She is as smart and thoughtful as they come, a truly great person. I will miss having her by my side, but when she approached me about pursuing other opportunities, I totally understood. I'm sure we will work together again in the future." The announcement comes one day after Hicks testified before the House Intelligence Committee, saying, among other things, that in her role, she occasionally had been required to tell what she called white lies, although she claims never to have lied about anything connected to the Russia investigation. However, the New York Times' Maggie Haberman reports Hicks's departure is not related to her testimony, and White House Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders says it's been in the works for, quote, several weeks and didn't happen overnight. Still, a White House official says Hicks told Trump about her decision yesterday, and several sources in and out of the White House tell NBC News they were shocked. This is the latest in a long list of major White House departures since Trump took office just over 13 months ago. So, at best, Joe, the timing's suspicious here. Literally the day after Hope Hicks testified before the Intel Committee, she walks away from the White House.
Right. The day after she testified, the day after a lot of people seized on the fact that she said she occasionally told little white lies. But I think more importantly, Elise, Jordan, it also comes at a time when the Mueller investigation is really starting to pick up. We had two reporters yesterday come on our show saying their sources inside the Mueller investigation say things are starting to move at a very rapid pace. Bob Mueller is not nibbling around the edges anymore. He's going straight in and he's asking the questions. did Donald Trump know about the Russian hacking of the DNC? Did he plan things out? Things are about to get pretty ugly inside the White House. And the question is, for somebody like Hope Hicks, why did you stay that long? I mean, there's not much good news for a lot of people. And Hope Hicks also, of course, involved in that Air Force One meeting, the drafting of the memo. She was just sort of a courier. But at the same time, I mean, she's got to get ready for Mueller. She's got to get ready for a trial. Things could get ugly.
Well, watching Hope Hicks over the course of the campaign and then her time in the administration, there were just so many moments where, you know, looking at it as a former press staffer, you would think, wow, how is she doing this? How is she, you know, able to stay when the president is, you know, say Charlottesville and saying there are very good people on both sides, or just the day-to-day chaos that comes with this administration. You look at how it collided with her personal life this year with the she was responsible for staging the response when Rob Porter, the staff secretary, was accused very credibly of beating his wives. And so she was involved in, you know, pulling down John Kelly with that response, you know, helping orchestrate the response to Orrin Hatch. And so someone who had really enjoyed one of the best reputations for being a professional operative in the Trump administration really saw that reputation tarnished a little bit. And then now that as the Mueller investigation has heated up, you know, it's less about giving testimony to the House committee yesterday, and that's the investigation that you really want to stay clear of.
Yeah, and Willie, you also have people talking about General Kelly. I'm not so sure that he had anything to do with this, but 2 days ago, we hear the news about Jared Kushner, an insider's insider for Trump, suddenly being shut out of certain classified material. Yesterday, the ultimate insider, Hope Hicks, leaves. I don't know if General Kelly had anything to do with it, but it is certainly something that he would want, which is get the Trump Tower people out, move in the professionals.
Yeah, and you can't overstate how close Hope Hicks has been to Donald Trump. She came up through the Trump organization, not through the presidential campaign or the White House. She worked with Ivanka many years ago and joined him from day one, literally, of his presidential campaign. You could hear in his statement and statements from Ivanka and others how much she meant to him. So we'll see the impact of him losing one more of his closest hands. Want to get now...